The opposition is not quite happy with the budget, stating that few sectors have been left out and feel that it's an incomplete budget, which B.S. Yediyurappa has presented. But nonetheless, seventh budget has been presented now and allocations have been done. Different sectors have been addressed, in particular Bengaluru as well. Well, just a short while back, we were discussing with Sagar as well with respect to what are the kind of allocations which have been done and how he sees the budget, even though he has said that the farmers have not benefited in particular with respect to the budget. Well, Sagar, you were saying the farmers in particular, they have not benefited from the budget. But on the other hand, Sumer, he has tried to concentrate mainly on the professional sectors. Like in Bengaluru, there are several aspects which need to be addressed. That has been addressed at this point in time. Education, on the other hand, Sumer, that has also been addressed with respect to how kids can be nurtured in the coming days as well. What would you like to say on that?
See, I'm an independent. I don't belong to a party, so I can critically analyze it. You know, what I feel is, take, say, supportive price for farmers. Where is supportive price for farmers? That's what they've been demanding for years. We don't want loan waivers. Give us supportive prices. That's what they've been asking. That hasn't been granted. I'll give you some examples of the things that they've mentioned. Muddenhalli, they've mentioned a project, right? Do you know Muddenhalli has a VTU center? And the center has been struggling for many days, many years for that matter. You know why? Because no water source. So you should have checked on these things before starting a new project in these areas. They're struggling without basic drinking water. And already VTU is thinking, why did we even start that project? Now we are talking about new project in the same place where there is severe scarcity of water. And then Chitradurga district also faces severe scarcity of water. Nothing's been mentioned about that. And then you say 1,500 diesel buses. On one hand, you talk about climate change. Okay, IPCC has given a number, 1.5 degrees. Goes beyond that, there'll be environmental reactions which can't be undone. And waste management, when you talk about urban development, look at waste management is a serious problem in Bangalore. What about that? Nothing much.
Well, actually, solid waste management has been mentioned here, close then, to 300 crore rupees.
Right?
Has
then you yourselves mentioned the deficiency in the project. Unless there is segregation of waste, which is a serious problem, which needs a lot of awareness, unless segregation of waste is done, you spend more money on segregating waste, let alone producing something out of it. You know, these kinds of things are crucial and we have to look into it carefully. And what about education? Is it all about service? Do you want to be only assembly plant? Do you want Karnataka to be just an assembly plant? I'll give an example. Apple phone, the idea comes from California. It's assembled in Foxconn in China. China, Foxconn gets ounce, peanuts for assembling Apple. But all the money goes to California. We need original ideas to be developed through education. So we need smart educational institution. For that, we need smart teachers who ought to be trained. What's been allocated for that? It's laughable if you look at it carefully. I mean, but it's no different than the previous government's budget, you know? So we don't have some bold steps taken, you know, which bring systemic changes as such. And then implementation is another problem in itself. As I said, will all the money allocated go to the contractors who support the party? Or will it actually be implemented? These are the things we should look at.